do love talking science with you because I don't know jack about it.
That means you're still curious and you've preserved that into adulthood.
I actually, this isn't even ready yet, but I bought your book last week on Amazon. I haven't been able to read it yet.
Oh, because I haven't...
Not because you were coming on. I actually didn't even know that, man. I just love you.
Wow.
I think you're so...
Oh, okay.
Yes.
Okay.
His new book is Letter from Astrophysicist. It's so cool. It's
yeah,
so
did
cool.
People...
So tell me about science. Help me. Help me.
Okay, so scientists
okay.
are kids who never grew up.
Oh, that's what artists are.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah. I mean, what are kids that you turn... What's under here? And what's this? You know, and they're taking things apart. They're basically experimenting. And as parents, we tend to over-constrain their experiments.
Yes.
You spend the first year of their lives teaching them to walk and talk. And the rest of their lives tell them to shut up and sit down.
Yes.
Am I right or wrong? That's what you do.
Were you
all right?
In my house?
Guilty.
Yeah. But I need you to explain a few things, like Sonic Boom. Go.
Love me some Sonic Boom.
Okay.
Oh.
I love Sonic.
Okay.
They got a lot of drink options.
Yeah, Sonic shakes. Yeah, yeah,
yeah.
So when you sing, when any of us makes any sound, the sound emanates at the speed of sound from you. Okay. Now suppose you start moving. Well, the sound that's in front of you is not leaving you as fast as the sound behind you. And there's a point where you move so fast... Wait, I hadn't even gotten that part yet. You move so fast that the sound that you make does not advance in front of you at all.
What?
Because you're going the speed of sound itself.
Oh, so you're
going
faster
than it. So when you try to make a sound and you go faster than it, all your sound goes behind you. And all that sound gathers up on a shock wave, and that shock wave, if it's an airplane, is moving through the air, and by the time it hits the ground, it's like, bam!
What?
That's the sonic
boom. Oh, you hear it later. Oh,
later,
that's what you're
because
saying.
Because it's
oh, okay.
faster than the sound that it generated.
Wow, I
yes.
wish I had science teacher.
By the way,
wait,
the sonic booms in our lives, the crack of a whip, that's a sonic boom at the tip of the whip.
The tip of the whip.
Yes. Yes.
That's amazing. Okay, Black.
Is every sentence musical to
Black,
you?
Black, every time. Every time.
The tip of the whip.
Black
I'll try
hole.
To, I'll try to give you some more of that by the end of the
I do want to know about black holes.
Oh, okay. You didn't yes. learn about black holes?
No, I didn't learn. No, because I feel like it was wasted on me. As a kid, you're okay. kind of like, it's over your head. Okay. Now I'm an adult and I'm into
Number
it.
One, avoid them.
Avoid them.
Yes.
Well, or who knows what's inside?
You want to go find out?
If Matthew McConaughey did, and her star, I'm just saying.
No, if you go inside a black hole, you will not ever come out to tell us what was there.
But where will you go?
Well, okay.
Where will we go?
Okay, all right, so.
If I didn't have children, I would totally go.
I'm going to tell you. Well, go bring them.
No, just in case it's not good. I'll suffer on my own.
Here's what happens. As you get near a black hole, the difference in gravity between your head and your feet begins to grow, which means your feet will fall towards the black hole faster than your head will.
Will I get taller?
Yes, yes.
I'm in.
However, the getting taller part will never cease.
Whoa.
And so it'll continue, they're called tidal forces, and your body will be stretched to the point where the tidal forces exceed the intermolecular forces that hold your flesh together. And so then your body will snap in two. Likely at the base of your waist, at the base of your spine. Then you, those two parts keep falling in, and then those two parts feel the forces, and they split into two pieces, and then four, and then eight, and you will bifurcate all the way down to this cosmic abyss.
Word of the day, bifurcate.
Bifurcate. And that's not even the worst of it.
What?
Okay. That's not even the worst.
We haven't gotten to the worst part.
No, the worst part is...
That was the fun
the
part.
The fabric of space and time narrows. It funnels down to a point. So you have a certain width up here, and you get extruded...
Oh, like my waist.
...the fabric of space, like toothpaste through a tube. So if you die in that way, we have a word for that. It's called spaghettification.
Is that a real word?
Yes, it is a real... Look it up. I composed a poem about black holes.
Do it.
Just to summarize what you just learned.
I bet it's terrifying.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
In this feet-first dive to this cosmic abyss, you will not survive because you will not miss. The tidal forces of gravity will create quite a calamity when you're stretched head to toe. Are you sure you want to go? Your body's atoms, you'll see them, will enter one by one. The event horizon will eat him, and you won't be having fun.
No, Neil, it's terrifying. What the hell just happened?
I'm sorry. Thanks.
I had a question I wanted to ask you. I think you've already answered it.
What's that?
What's the scariest thing about the universe?
Oh, it's not falling into a black hole.
That's that's not the worst?
No. There's way scarier stuff than that. In 5 billion years, the sun will become bloated. It will expand so large.
I get that.
That it...
I get that. I expand every month.
I love this woman.
Every month, it just gets bigger, and then it goes back down. Okay, go.
Okay, so... How can I continue now?
Because I'm bloated right now. This dress is tight. Okay.
All right. The sun, in 5 billion years, will bloat to become so large, it will engulf the entire orbits of Mercury and Venus. Surface will be so near to Earth that Earth's temperature will rise exponentially. And the oceans will come to a rolling boil as they evaporate into the atmosphere. And then the atmosphere will evaporate into space. And we will be this charred ember as we get absorbed by the sun, descending into the crucible that is its burning center.
Holy, what?
Have a nice day.
Yeah. There's no segue here. I just want to, you know, kind of gear us away from terrifying.
Okay.
when I did your show a couple years ago, we talked about the Great American Eclipse.
Yeah.
Which I actually saw in my at my farm.
I was so jealous because I spent all this money to go to a mountaintop, and I could have just been invited to your backyard. Is my invitation still in my inbox?
Did I
miss the invitation?
No, honestly, it was a last minute thing. We were so busy.
No, eclipses are not last minute things.
No,
people can plan their whole life around eclipses.
I know,
not people. Barbecue. Like me. Oops, there's an eclipse. Is that what happened in your backyard in Tennessee?
It really was. It was at our farm.
Well, need some scientists down there.
Everybody was like, hey, we should go to your farm and see the eclipse. We were like, okay. And we went down there. Okay. Stopped at a gas station, got some glasses.
Okay.
It was awesome.
All right.
And all the animals, everything started making noise. The crickets, everything started making, they thought it was nighttime.
And the craziest behaving animals are the humans.
We were pretty nuts. But we were drinking too. So. But wait, I want to leave everyone with a little hope, okay? Because we've gone a little zero dark 30. And I'm scared to walk into my house now. And I never want to go near a black hole. So just maybe give us something hopeful.
From the universe.
Yes.
Derived from a cosmic...
Something beautiful that makes us smile.
The atoms of your body are traceable to events that have long ago occurred in the universe, especially stars that have manufactured these elements and exploded, scattering that enrichment across the galaxy, enabling planets to form and life upon them. So when you stand outside and look up at the night sky, it's not we're here and the stars are there. We are a participant in this great unfolding cosmic journey. And it is not just figuratively true, it is literally true that we are stardust.
So we're all stars.
It is not that we are in the universe. That's true. But what's even more true is that the universe is in us.
I totally want to name my next album, The Universe Within Me. I will not stop talking until you subscribe to my YouTube channel. That's right, and I can talk a lot. Seriously, not gonna stop. Yep, still here, not going anywhere. I see you. Don't walk away from this.